Hey, everybody. Well, it turned out okay. Some of you may have seen the two previous videos where I assemble this little airplane kit. It's made of wood, and it's supposed to be a model of a Curtiss Goshawk biplane. It turned out okay. I added a couple of details that were not part of the kit, such as this little, see if I can get a good angle here. This little scoop underneath the fuselage. And this scoop right here. Normally a machine gun would go right here. I chose to put this little scoop instead of a machine gun. Don't ask me what the scoop is for, because I don't know. I just like the way it looked. Here's the propeller. After it's painted, the propeller is going to go right here. Now, I'm not interested in painting this plane to the exact colors of the real plane, the prototype plane. I'm going to paint this plane blue and yellow. The fuselage will be blue. Blue violet in this case. I have an assortment of brushes. I think I'll use this one. Start on the bottom. As you can see, I've already primed the plane. I used a can of just gray primer. I'm Minute may take a couple of coats. This. Squirt just a little bit more paint into my container. I'm going to mix it just a little bit. It's kind of watery. I used to build model airplanes when I was a kid. And until I built this one, it's been a while since I've put together an airplane. Just trying to get the paint onto the plane. Later on, when it's time, we'll be far more careful than we are right now. This paint is, it's just some acrylic paint from my wife's studio. I hope she doesn't miss it. Back in the 30s, the military had a plane designated a PT-17. It was a biplane, and it was a training plane, I do believe. Typically, they were yellow and blue, and I've always liked that paint scheme, and that's why I'm painting this Curtis Goshawk in that same paint scheme. It's not prototype, but I don't really care. This isn't meant to be prototypical. it's meant to be the way I want it to be. Back in the 60s and the 70s, the toy company named Cox, C-O-X, they made little gas-powered vehicles and airplanes. They had the PT-17 trainer. It was a control line model, which means that you basically flew it around in a circle. It was attached to a string. I don't even know if that company is still in business. I'll leave that gray for now. Building this little kit was a lot of fun. I picked this kit up at Harbor Freight. I think it only cost a couple of dollars. And it's not meant to be a scale model. It's meant to be a toy airplane. The features of the plane, like these supports, were way too big to be scale. My wife has been out of town for a few days now, so me and the dog and the cat have had the place to ourselves. She'll be coming home in a couple more days. I have some picking up I need to do. I don't know if I'll leave these wing supports blue or if I'll paint them silver. I'll decide that in a little while. I probably should have shaken the bottle of paint more than I did. Perhaps it may have been a little bit thicker. I've been researching a problem with this camera that I use. Sometimes some of you have mentioned that you can hear some kind of digital sounds in the audio that are very annoying. Sometimes you can even hear clicking. It turns out that there's a problem with inexpensive camcorders like this. The autofocus system is continuously trying to keep the subject in focus, and the noise of the mechanism will actually be audible on the video. And there's not really anything that can be done about it. and for the digital beeping, and I think that is the charging system for the battery making noise. Right now, I do not have the battery in the camera, so I'm curious to see how the audio comes out on this video. I have decided to use a different camera in the future. But until I save up enough money to get the camera, I'll continue to use this camera. That just about does it for the initial first coat. The top of the wing is going to be yellow. Now, all of the features that shouldn't be yellow and shouldn't be blue will not be yellow and will not be blue. Things such as the tires, those will be black. I'm not sure why, but I'm painting this plane has brought back a memory of a 1970s TV series called Baba Black Sheep. It was a bunch of guys, a squadron of aces, pilots, in the Pacific during World War II. And they flew Corsairs. I I don't know why I thought of that, but maybe some of you have seen some old episodes of Ba Ba Black Sheep. Is complete. I'll do the second coat after a while. Be sure to tune in to episodes of this painting the plane that will follow.